With today's technologies, new moms have a lot of options when it comes to getting early insight into their developing baby's genetic health. How do we know which prenatal screening options are right for us? Here with today's report is Amber Mills.
More than 4 million babies are born in this country each year, and a majority arrive healthy and full term. But that doesn't stop 78% of mothers-to-be from worrying about potential birth defects. Non-invasive prenatal testing, also referred to as NIPT, is a relatively new option in screening that can get you some of the insights you're looking for about your baby's health and reduce some of that anxiety. Here to help us navigate is Patty Taneja. She's a genetic counselor from Illumina. Patty, thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
So Patty, I know so many women right now who are either pregnant or trying to get pregnant, and it seems like there's so much to worry about. Is this test for women who are over a certain age, or are there certain risk factors?
So information about the genetic health of your developing baby is important for moms at any age. Every woman who is pregnant has a chance or risk of having a baby with a certain type of chromosome condition, like Down syndrome. The American College of Obstetricians and Gynecologists actually recommend that all pregnant women, regardless of age, be offered screening or testing during pregnancy for these common chromosome conditions. Screening has been around for a very long time. NIPT is the first prenatal screening option that actually looks at DNA from the developing pregnancy without needing to do an invasive procedure like an amniocentesis or chorionic villus sample, also known as CVS.
Okay, you mentioned NIPT is a screening test and not a diagnostic test. Can you explain the difference between the two?
Sure. So a screening test is one that will tell you if your pregnancy is at a higher chance for having one of the conditions screened for, but it doesn't give you a definite answer. A diagnostic test will give you a yes or no answer to whether that condition is present. However, in order to do these diagnostic tests, they're invasive procedures, and they do carry with them a small risk for miscarriage or pregnancy loss. Some women will start with a screening test and then use that information to decide if they'd like to pursue diagnostic testing later in pregnancy.
Okay, so what exactly is NIPT?
So NIPT is a very simple, non-invasive blood draw that's safe for both mom and baby. It can be done as early as 10 weeks in pregnancy, and often women have it in the first trimester. There are several different terms that are used for NIPT, so people might be familiar with other terminology like cell-free DNA testing or non-invasive prenatal screening, or NIPS. When you do this blood draw, what you have is DNA that's circulating in mom's blood from the pregnancy. These little fragments of DNA can be analyzed to see if you have the correct or expected number of chromosomes present in that developing pregnancy. If the correct number of chromosomes is not present, so if an abnormality is determined, then this can have serious effects on the health and development of the baby.
So what exactly is NIPT screening for?
So NIPT looks for common chromosomal conditions that occur during pregnancy. These are ones that are not typically inherited, meaning there's not a family history, but they're more likely to happen by chance. So one that people are most familiar with is an extra copy of chromosome 21. This is also called trisomy 21 or Down syndrome. So NIPT screens for that, as well as trisomy 18 or Edwards syndrome, trisomy 13 or Petit syndrome, or differences in the sex chromosomes, which are X and Y. There are some NIPT tests that have expanded panels that are available as well, which can also look at smaller missing pieces of DNA on different chromosomes or other more rare chromosome abnormalities.
Okay, so let's talk a little bit about what the results are telling us and then how we're going to use that information.
Results of your NIPT can come back showing that the expected number of chromosomes is found for your pregnancy, meaning that you can be reassured that your developing baby doesn't have one of these chromosome conditions. On the other hand, results can come back showing that an abnormal number of chromosomes was detected, meaning that you are at a higher chance for having one of these conditions in your pregnancy. Now, any screening test can have a positive test result, and that condition is actually not present in the pregnancy. And this is called a false positive. The good news with NIPT is that the chance of having a false positive is much lower than with any other prenatal screening option. There is also a chance that you could have a normal, reassuring NIPT test result, but your pregnancy does actually still have one of these conditions tested for. This is called a false negative. There are many different types of NIPT that are available, so it's important that you talk to your doctor about which specific NIPT you've had, how the test is performed, what conditions it tests for, and what the chances are that you'll have what's known as a test failure, meaning that no test result is able to be reported to you. NIPT is superior to any of the other screening options as far as the accuracy and the detection rate of these conditions. So if you have a normal reassuring NIPT result, you can feel very good about that.
I still think it's amazing that women have so many options nowadays because it seems like there's so much to consider mm-hmm. when you're a mom-to-be. What would you tell women who are considering NIPT?
Well, I think the decision to screen or test for chromosome conditions during pregnancy is a very personal decision. And I would encourage a woman who's considering this to think about what this information would provide. Would it allow for her and her family to prepare for the future? A person could consider speaking with their healthcare provider or a genetic counselor about what a positive test result could mean for their developing baby. Lastly, most women will get a negative test result, which gives them reassurance about the health of their developing baby.
Thank you so much for being here, Patty. You know, I think what it comes down to is with today's new technologies, new moms have a lot of options to get some early insight into their baby's health, and that's a great thing. For more information on the non-invasive prenatal testing option discussed today, visit illumina.com, and you can always go to our website, accesshealth.tv. We'll see you next time. Mm-hmm.